Whatever ragas and dveshas came up today during short kriya meditation, when you wanted to lie down and I didn't let you lie down, and meditation started, see that dvesha that came up, put it down.
But that is not temporary, right? It's not going to be in 2 minutes. Or if it was not there in 30 seconds after that.
Yeah, but then it keeps repeating, keeps repeating, keeps repeating. If I have sand here and I just punch once, I said, oh, it's one punch. But every day I do the same punch, same punch, same punch. What will happen in a month? It's a big hole. And what will happen in a year? It's a big well. That is an impression on your mind. In the beginning you say, oh, it's only a small little dvesha, it's small little raga, it lasted only 10 seconds, it went away. I got angry, I screamed and shouted at him or her, and then it went away, I was fine. No, don't fool yourself. You made that impression, right? Even if it was a 10 second impression, how long does it take to do this? 1 second, that impression is there on the mind. Are you getting it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So don't try to find an escape route. Your mind is trying to find an escape route. Oh, I don't have many ragas and dveshas. Your mind is saying that 100% you have many, many more that is hidden on the carpet. So put those down.
Maybe we love the meditation, that's all for raga.
If it just gave you peace and you enjoyed the peace, you enjoyed your true nature. Yes? If in raga of meditation or kriya, I tell everybody, get out, don't bring the baby here. The baby should not scream. What is this?
Raga.
It's my raga acting up, creating a dvesha. Did you come up with this? Every raga has a dvesha hidden behind it. Every dvesha has a raga hidden behind it. Did you come up with this realization? Now at least? No? Look very closely at one of your ragas. And identify what is the corresponding dvesha. For example, let's say you have a simple raga of keeping everything clean. Lots of wives have it. Yeah? And husbands throw shoes around. What happens to you? I've just cleaned the whole house and you want to just throw things around. See? Huh? Raga for perfection led to dvesha for messy husband. Yeah? It can be the other way around. I just gave a very filmy example right now. But observe, every raga of yours has a corresponding dvesha. And every dvesha has a corresponding raga. Yeah? Take 5 to 10 minutes, identify and fill your bags up. Have you watched the karma video? Yeah, so you know what is raga and dvesha. Just put down your ragas and dveshas now in the bank. Did you watch the karma video? No? You're going to be a little lost today, huh? Once in a while, someone does something that hurts everyone, including themselves. And you can see they harm everyone for no reason. And if I don't say anything, something inside pinches me. How to avoid this? See, if something is pinching you, it means you need to say something. Yes? If there is something wrong in any situation where you think you need to take an action, take an action. But how will you take an action? Yes, without creating a dvesha for me. Because what would that do for me?
Impression.
It'll create an impression. What will that impression do?
Karma.
It'll create avami karma. For me only. Yeah? So if I need to take an action, how do I take an action?
Without any attachment.
Without any attachment. What is the meaning of attachment?
Raga and
shame. Yeah, no emotion, no anger, no hatred, no jealousy, no putting that person down, no condescending another person. None of that. Yeah, you just see that this situation needs correction. I get up, do that action, wash my hands off. No attachment that the other person should listen to me even. That is an expectation. Expectation is an impression. Are you seeing this?
Mm-hmm.
I expect something from you. You don't do it for me. What happens to me inside?
All burnings.
Burning begins. Anger begins. Yeah. More expectation increases. More you don't do, more my anger increases. Yeah. Then feverishness starts. Oh, you are not doing this. You should be doing this. Then fights start. I'm just going on punching the sand more and more and more and more impressions are happening. Have you seen this? Without feverishness, this situation requires an action from me. I do the action, wash my hands off. Done. No attachment to the result of this action also. Yeah, the previous chapters we've done. Some of you have done, some of you have not done the previous chapters with me. Where Lord Krishna says, don't get attached to even the fruit of action. You do pure action and move on. Yes?
Like how Guruji reacted to Zakir Hussain's comment. He didn't react. As audience, we were getting so angry. He was so cool and not even reacting.
Yeah, absolutely. Because it doesn't touch that consciousness. Yeah? It's just that prakriti, no? To whom, which is being criticized or said something to. He is not the prakriti. He's just in that piece of flesh because that is the way we humans understand. Would we fathom something formless sitting here? Would you be able to hear that formless? Would you be able to understand or perceive that formlessness? No. He had to take a particular form to convey some message to us, some wisdom to us. Yes? See the reason why he is there in that form. And then if somebody criticizes, it doesn't matter to him. That form is just a vehicle. They are criticizing that particular body. They are criticizing some action related to that body. But he is the Purusha and he's established in the Purusha. He is not lost in the Prakriti. Yeah? What happens to us? We are lost so much in our Prakriti. Yeah? You said something to Ekta. Oh, you said something to Ekta. How dare you say this? I am so attached to this body called Ekta. But really, it's just the body that is called Ekta. In my previous lifetime, I must have been a butterfly. I was not called Ekta. In the next lifetime, I could be a goat. You never know. Yeah. We are so attached because we cannot see the entire existence as it is. We just are attached to this particular birth, death, the next particular birth, death. He can see it in his entire existence. The entire equation from end to end is visible to him. So he does not get attached to one little prakriti, one little comment from somebody. It doesn't matter. Yes? You have to get there. The reason a guru comes to you is to give you that message that you can withdraw from this feverishness of prakriti and establish in Purusha. That is who you are. That is the entire leela. Got it?
Then what does live in the Prasambhavat mean?
Exactly that. Being in the Purusha is the present moment. Here and now. Moment to moment to moment. Somebody said one word to me. This moment is past. Yeah? I hold on to that past and sit. And you sit and boil and boil and boil and boil. Guruji says, drop, move on, present moment. Again that present moment is gone. Again move on. Present moment, it's gone. Got it? Being in the Purusha is equal to being in the present moment. Is equal to Sakshi Bhava. Vaishtavakra. They're different terminologies used by different saints. We'll do all of them. If you've not done, it's okay. We'll get there soon. Yeah?
What if it is other way around? Like, there is a situation where we just told something, like, at the time you were not aware, but as soon as it was done, it aware and it pinched you that something was not to be said. And you burst into tears or you feel really bad. How do you take care of that situation?
Whatever. Apologize. Now that you know that you made a mistake, apologize with earnestness. What do? We apologize, which gives us the power to repeat the same situation again. I've apologized. I'm a good person now. That's what I do. Yeah? Thappad maro, sorry. Thappad maro, fir sorry. Fir thappad maro, fir sorry. What's the point? I'm actually giving myself an excuse to repeat the mistake. That is wrong. That is not even a sincere apology. Are you seeing what I'm saying? A sincere apology is not through the lips. It is an inner cleansing. Come what may, I am not going to repeat this going ahead.
So if we can't find a person, so is it okay if we write it down and...
Surrender it to Guruji, surrender it to God, whoever you believe in, Krishna, Rama, Jesus, doesn't matter. Yeah? Somewhere start your cleansing process. Enough of excusing yourself. Yeah? Again and again and again you excuse yourself, again you repeat the same mistake. That is called a habit pattern. Yeah?
This Guru Purnima, Guruji was telling something about this, that our word should come only till the throat, it should not go deep down.
Yes.
He was giving the example of Lord Shiva and Nilakanta, or he was telling the story.
Yes. Yeah. From here, there should be no emotion.
Emotion.
What is peace, really? Peace.
Maybe that is feeling of mind.
When there is no mind,
where there is no mind, where there is no emotion. Yeah, when do you say I'm at peace with myself? When there is no chitter chatter going on here. And there is no emotion also here. No anger, no hatred, no jealousy, no, even not love, even not passion, nothing. Just silence here and silence here. That's when you say I'm at peace right now. Happens in the advanced course, silence course sometimes. Yeah. Sometimes if you are a painter, when you play the piano or something, when you're just in your art, you're absolutely peaceful. Have you noticed? Yeah. Peace is equal to no mind and no emotion. Just pure silence is peace. Got it? Yeah. That is why act in this world just as a drama. You went on stage, you acted as Rama and Sita. Yeah, then you came down from the stage. You dropped that, no? Did you continue being Rama or Sita for the rest of your life? No, no. But you continue drama wherever you go. Observe this. You have been given the role of a husband, a wife, a friend, a boyfriend, a daughter, a son, a mother, a father. You just play your role that time with 100% authenticity. Yeah. Being 100% with that job. Yes. But all the time recognizing, I am not this Prakriti which is behaving like a father or mother or friend right now. I am that Purusha within. I am that silence within. Yeah. Again and again, withdraw from the Prakriti to the Purusha. Only you can do this. A master can show you the way. A master can teach you the technique. But that if you do just for that 20 minutes, 30 minutes, whatever, 1 hour, and you're back to your normal drama the moment you open your eyes from Kriya. Hey, get out of here. What are you doing here? Finished. No peace, you've spoilt your entire peace. You have to learn to cultivate this during the day with your eyes open. You see what I'm saying? And only you can do it. And how? Withdrawing from the Prakriti, coming back to the Purusha. Yes? See, right now you are looking at me. Who is looking at me?
The five senses.
Okay, squeeze your eyes. Squeeze, squeeze. Now look. Who's looking? Okay, now take your attention just to the eyes that you squeezed. Who's looking at your own eyes? So there is something inside which is different from the eyes, different from the five senses. Yeah? That's something inside. Now just observe that. Close your eyes. That is still there. The seer, the observer. Close your eyes. That seer or the observer is also listening to the music. Take one more step back, and there is a witnessing consciousness which is not doing anything. It is just a witness. It is a witness to eyes closed. It was a witness to eyes open. Take a deep breath in. It is a witness to the in-breath. And breathe out. It is a witness to the out-breath. That is the self. That is the Purusha. Abide there. That is who you are. And when you feel complete, very slowly you may open your eyes. Could you understand it? At least a glimpse? Not at all. Anybody didn't understand at all. So you got a glimpse of what I'm saying. Yes, the one inside which is not doing anything, which is not saying anything, yeah? Which does not eat, it does not even sleep, it does not say anything. It's just a witness. What is a witness? What is the meaning of the word witness?
Don't do anything, just
that which is just there. That's it, like a catalyst. Chemistry lab? Mm. Yeah, 11th standard, 12th standard, remember? Chemistry lab, catalyst. A catalyst is just there, required for hydrogen and oxygen to combine and become water. What is the catalyst? Electricity. It doesn't do anything, it's just there. It does not interfere in the reaction. It doesn't cause the reaction to happen. It just is. That's what the Purusha is. just a witness. It is. That's who you are. Not the one who's screaming and shouting at the kids or getting angry with the husband or wife, yeah, or screaming at the girlfriend or boyfriend. No. That is just Prakriti. Got it? Yes. Understanding Prakriti is Vijnana. Understanding this Purusha is
Jnana.
Are you getting it? Not by reading scriptures, not by byhearting sutras from the Bhagavad Gita. Are you going to get it? How are you going to get it? Again and again, separating out from the Prakriti. Again and again, taking a step back. In whatever drama you are involved in, the house, at work, in school, with friends, in art of living also, there's a lot of drama. They're also taking a step back. Oh, I am the Purusha, not the Prakriti that is doing all this. Yes? Just being established again and again and again in the witnessing consciousness is Jnana. Nobody can give me the Jnana. A master can only show you this is the technique. But I have to make an effort. Got it? Jnana is self. That is why it is called self-knowledge in English. Yeah? It's Swabhava Jnana. It's not Prabhava. What is Prabhava Jnana?
Externally influenced.
From other people. He says like this, she says like this. Even the guru is the other. He is saying from his experience. Has it become my experience?
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because I have still not put an effort. Yes, I listen to the master because he is the one who has reached there. Now I have to make an effort. If I listen to the master and say, wow, fantastic Guruji, what's the point? You're watching a Shah Rukh Khan movie or what? He's not craving for your claps. He's not craving for you running behind him, giving him roses. No, he wants you to get enlightened. Are you seeing what I'm saying? He's not a rock star, guys. He's not craving for your praises and whatever. He wants only one thing, that you follow his path and you get enlightened. Yes, the Buddha said it will happen only by direct observation. What was direct observation? We just did it a few minutes ago. We closed our eyes, we went in and we, made an effort to establish in that silence the witnessing consciousness. That is what is an effort, a self-effort from my side. Yes, Purushartha from my side, or in Buddha's language, direct observation. I'm giving you these words. These are from all the different scriptures that we study in Art of Living. Means the same thing.
We can only observe that when we are peaceful. That's only possible by again our practices.
Yes. So now you will say, oh, I'm not peaceful, so it's okay, I won't do it.
No.
To become peaceful, you have to learn to separate yourself from the Prakriti. Again and again and again. Till that time, you will not experience peace. It's not possible. Are you getting it? Yes? So it has to be a constant effort from your side. That is what Guruji is teaching you right from day one. What is the basic key point of Art of Living Happiness Program?
Present moment.
Live in the?
Present moment.
Present moment. Being established in the Purusha is living in the present moment. See, give it to you on the day one. Yeah, how many of us got it? Yeah, understanding it now. It's opening up. It'll open up more and more as we go deeper in the sutras. But are your bags full now?
Little bit.
Huh?
a question. Yesterday Guruji talked about the benefits of doing yoga, and he talks 4 points. And the last point, where he talked about ultimate knowledge.
Ultimate truth.
So when we talk about that, we are relating that from going from vijnana to jnana.
Vijnana
to jnana.
Yes. What is the truth?
We are not all this. We are the Purusha.
Truth is not taken by the time.
Everything is changing.
Everything is changing is the truth. Sounds like one sentence. Don't use the intellect. Really see, everything is changing. People are changing. People's minds are changing. Things around you are changing. Trees are growing. Summer is coming. Then winter is coming. Everything is changing in the external environment. In this body, moment to moment, everything is changing. Yes? Forget other people's mind. My only mind keeps changing all the time. My emotions keep changing all the time. Everything is changing means everything is temporary. Temporary means?
Nothing lasts.
Temporary means
only for a limited.
Has an expiry date. How do I hold on to things? As if it's going to be with me forever. Oh, my child, my husband, my wife, my boyfriend, my girlfriend. My God, the end of the world it is. See how your mind behaves. Yes, the ultimate truth is everything in this Prakriti is changing. When you recognize this, oh, everything is changing and I am holding on to that which is changing. It's like you are sitting in a train and so fast the scenery keeps changing and you are trying to hold on to a tree, you are trying to hold on to a person you see walking outside. It's changing, it's moving, everything is moving. Yes? So that means something must be not changing. If I am observing everything changing, obviously I am not changing. But I observe that this body is changing. Then who is this I that is not changing? Are you seeing it? Now I come from the Prakriti to the understanding of that non-changing. And that non-changing is the Purusha, the ultimate truth. Got it?
A couple more questions can I ask? Guruji also talks about the skin being observed under the microscope. And he talks about the vast space between, it's difficult to even imagine. I mean, we see that, it's I don't know how to imagine that, but the vast space and emptiness, and he compares to the Buddhas, and it's hollow and empty. So is there anything that I can really relate to and imagine the vast
space? You don't
space
have to imagine. Huh? First of all, read up on quantum mechanics. Yeah? Start from basics. I sent you the video. It is there in the prerequisites list. After karma video is the quantum mechanics. How many of you even went to the second video? Only one person in the whole class. Yeah. So look up science. Science as scientists tell you. Okay. Start from vijnana. What will that do? That will silence a lot of doubt in your mind. Yeah? The intellect will get its understanding. We are not all scientists yet. So we've not reached that stage to even understand what science has proven. Yeah, because we've not made that effort from our side. So at least start there. Yeah. You will come to a point where you will understand, oh really, this body is just something that can be compressed. Remove the water, remove the air, remove the space. Yeah. What is left of the earth can be compressed and put inside a matchbox. Only that much earth element is there in you. The other is all space and water and air inside you. And fire keeps you, your life moving. That's what actually you are. So start with some scientific videos. I'll share with you some if you're interested in all these things. You really need a scientific mind, huh? Because if you don't have a scientific temper, in 5 minutes you are going to give up. Did you like physics class?
No.
Yes. That's no. The problem there.
just for marks.
Now do it out of real thirst to understand. Sit with a pen and book. Yeah, start the YouTube video. Every 5 minutes, pause, write it down. Did you understand? Maybe slowly, that's how your understanding will open up. Yeah, start with these basic videos. I'll send to you what videos to start with.
Maybe one more thing, like you always talk that, you know, we are not. So whenever you say like you are not the body, or you know, always there's a little conflict now, because I understand that I'm not what it is from Ashok or whatever the previous sessions. So when you talk like, you know, you are the body or something, it's a little confusing to me.
You are not the body.
Yeah, you are not the body. But like in the class when you say like, you know, see, you are doing this, see, you are observing, or you are listening, or you are wearing this. I'm like, I'm not wearing this, right? So how do I like, you know, still think that, listen that, and still not, you know, shake up and still come and to understand that?
So recognize that it is just the Purusha, the witnessing consciousness inside you, that is giving this body that strength to even talk, to even speak right now, to get up in the morning and decide not to wear a green dress. Yes. So recognizing that the body is a separate function, mind is a separate function, intellect is a separate faculty, just like in a computer, monitor separate, yeah, the keyboard is separate, the mouse is separate. Like that, I have different parts, yeah. And the main one that actually makes this all unit run, yeah, that is the witnessing consciousness. At death, what happens? This witnessing consciousness drops this entire body or this unit. Will they function the moment this consciousness has left?
No.
This cannot function. So how can I be that which cannot function after the next 30, 40, 50 years? Can I be that? Recognize this. I am not the body. I am not the mind. I am not the intellect. These are tools that I have. Yes, I am actually self-hypnotized. I have forgotten who I am. I have started identifying with this mind, with this intellect, with this memory, with this false ego. That is the problem. I have hypnotized myself thinking I am these tools. It's like you went and sat in your beautiful new Mercedes car, my beautiful car. My beautiful car. You kept sitting in it and you forgot that you are separate from the car. Do you become the car? Can you just sit in the garage forever? That's exactly what has happened. The Purusha has to step out of this car and recognize I am separate from this. However, I don't know how much ever Mercedes car got. $100,000 car. It's just an attachment, nothing else.
Just one more question. Like, so, like you just said, like the Purusha in me, like for example, I just decided this is the dress I want to wear. That's not exactly the Purusha deciding, like it's the intellect, the mind.
It's the mind's attachment to the green dress. Okay. Because somebody in the past complimented, green looks very beautiful, Anipandana. That stuck as an impression in the mind. Yeah. Now memory, what it does, it jogs up that particular impression, tells you, you know, you got a compliment on this dress. Wear green dress today. The mind goes and pulls the green dress out. Are you seeing how this functioning happens? It's exactly like a computer. Yeah, recognize this is happening inside me. Yeah, you have to slowly open up. You are very closed right now. Yeah, because you've identified with this 200 pounds, 300 pounds, whatever your pound piece of prakriti, thinking this is who I am. This is just the hardware. Software is somewhere inside.
So don't we need those things to play their role?
Yes, yes. But you cannot become their slave, no? You become their slave. You use a hammer to just put the nail in the wall. Do you carry the hammer all day with you? My hammer. Oh, my hammer. My hammer. That's what you're doing. You have become the slave of the tools. You've become a slave of this body. You've become a slave of the attachments of the mind. Recognize this. Anything that I see, I want to possess it. I possess it and then I don't want to lose it. I've become a slave to that. Isn't it? Yeah. Anything that I taste, oh, one gulab jam. No, no, one more gulab jam. One more gulab jam. Something I just went to taste and now I have become a slave to the gulab jam. And then I become nice and beautiful. And the doctor says, this is too beautiful. You need to become a little less beautiful. Yeah. Why? Because I became a slave to the gulab jam. You see?
Maybe again, I did not become that. It's the body which became. So that's what that's where I'm
you have become. Till the time Purusha does not learn to separate from the Prakriti, the Purusha has become a slave to the Prakriti. So you have become a slave.
Okay.
The day you learn to separate out and command, I am the master and I am not a slave of that gulab jam or whatever, you are a slave of that beautiful girl or sex or money or name or fame. The day you pronounce, I am the master, then you are no more a slave.
Purusha cannot be a slave, right? I mean, must be masked.
This it is
like
the Maya.
Yeah.
The Maya that hypnotizes this Purusha into thinking that I am the Prakriti. Yeah? So you become the master. Stop being the slave of these small little objects of your senses. Yes, they are just objects of sight or sound. Somebody says few words to me. Yeah, your nose is crooked. Finish. Full night you will be imagining your nose is crooked and not sleeping. Are you seeing this? No rest for you. Yeah. Why did he say this to me? Why did she say this to me? Recognizing this, that, oh, I am not the Prakriti. And even those words came from somebody that is also Prakriti. Separate out, separate out. Yeah. It's all temporary. Stop being a slave. The moment you separate yourself out and recognize, oh, I am the king, I am the master, it drops off.
It's not like a line which you cross, right? The line is so mixed up, you know, with everything else that
it's very subtle. You don't know when you've crossed over.
Yeah, when you say, you know, like cross over, it's actually the mind observing the mind. Because even for the mind to go beyond the Purusha, I mean, go like, or get dissolved, I mean, it needs so much
effort.
Sadhana.
Yes.
Yeah.
Self-effort is required. Yeah, not just sadhana, meditation, those 20, 30 minutes that you're doing. Throughout the day, continue self-effort to separate from this Prakriti. Yes?
Maybe Detroit is a good place for that. A lot of people are driving long distances to come here. And maybe a good exercise would be, while you're driving those distances, turn off all music, don't call anyone, just see how that 1.5 hour goes in that crazy traffic.
Yes.
That's a great opportunity.
What is he telling you to do?
Withdraw from
direct observation. Observe how you are sitting at that wheel. Yeah, observe your mind. Observe all the memories that come up. Any memory that comes up is an impression, is karma. Otherwise, the memory would not come up. Any thought that comes up is a karma. Otherwise, it would not come up. Observe any emotions that come up because of some thought. You thought about one person, your boss saying this last week to you, inside you feel a punch. You don't feel so good. He said this, oh my God, I'm going to get fired. And then the fire starts inside. Have you noticed? And you create another big Manohar Kahani inside you. A big story of your own inside you. Have you noticed? And you start fantasizing. What if this happens, then that happens. And then he kicks me out and then I don't find a job. And then I lose my salary. And then what happens? I can't pay my mortgage. And then this one. Have you noticed? One memory from the past kicks me so hard, I go on fantasizing into the future. Constantly, mind is either in the past or in the future. Yes? Again and again, just observe, observe, bring it to the present, here, now. Yes? The boss does not exist right now. What if right now I meet with an accident and die? Do I want to keep thinking about the boss?
No.
I'll be born as his or her son. Do I want that? No. Yeah. Again and again, you know, the mind needs one little tap, one little slap. Present moment, here, now. Now, if it's too lost in its fantasy or in the past, pick up the danda and hit. You mother your mind. How you mother a very mischievous child? Yeah. First, you are firm with the child. Child does not listen. Then you really raise your tone. Yeah. Child does not listen. Yeah. Then you scream, shout, and finally you pick up the danda, no? You have to do the same thing with your mind. Mother your own mind. Yeah. Observe, 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 and bring it to the present. Again and again. Actually, if you 100% observe it only, it will come to the present. What is the meaning of observing?
Witness.
Witness means not jumping up and you start talking. Usually what happens? A thought comes from the past. He said this to me, that my job was not done well. What do I do?
Why did he say
no, but I do my job very well. I started talking to the mind. Have you noticed? There's an inner dialogue that I start. Then this says something, then I say something, then this says something. I have to learn to stop this talking. Yeah. So even if this thought comes, I observe it and let it go. Again, another thought comes. It kicks an emotion. So now I have a thought to observe and an emotion I'm feeling inside to observe. And let it come and go. Don't start an inner dialogue. The moment you start an inner dialogue, you are not witnessing anymore. Got it? A witness does not start inner dialogue. A witness does not get involved. Clear?
So being witness makes you mechanical. You know, just in the 2 minutes, I was being a witness. I'm like, to no emotions, nothing. But how does love come into this? You know, like a mother can't have a meaning. Be a witness to her son, right?
You can. In every action, doing it like you did a drama on stage. Remember you were Ram or whatever, Sita if you were. Yeah? You did that acting so 100%. Manoj became Ram for those half an hour, 1 hour, whatever, 2 hours play. You're not really Ram. But you did so well, no, 100%. Inside you knew you're Manoj. And this is a drama and it's going to end in the next 1 or 2 hours. Yes, that constant recognition of who I am was there. That is what is required in life. A constant recognition of I am the Purusha. And this is just a role I am playing. 200% as a mother, as a father, as a friend, whatever your role is.
Yes. Is it juicy?
It's juicier than what you are doing. Yeah, you feel so strong, so powerful. There is no love like this love. That love is only business attachment. You say I love you to me, okay, then I'll say I love you to you. You don't say I love you, forget it. No love for you today. Business transaction, trade. There's no love there. Yeah? You listen to me. You're a good child. You don't listen to me, you're a bad child. Business transaction, trade. It's not love. It's just a shadow of the real love that you will experience when you are truly in that witnessing consciousness. That's what Gurudev is. That is why there is no favoritism for him. Everybody is the same. There is same love for everyone. Have you met him? Have you seen him? Everybody? Yes? It may appear to you the other person gets a chance to go in and I don't get. He's going for work. Don't worry. He's not going to get any more 1 minute with Gurudev for personal time more than you. Yeah? So don't get into these things. These are also created by the mind. This is also a raga of the mind. And if you don't believe me, run behind him and see. Run for 2 years, 3 years, 5 years. At the end, you'll feel like that dog who keeps running behind that car and then wins and then stands in front of the car and he looks around. Okay, now what? I won. Now what? You are going to feel that. I guarantee you this. It is just a craving of the mind. And why is this craving there? Is the mind really craving for the object, Guru?
No.
Have you noticed when you were a little kid, you craved for toys?
Some desire.
You grew up a little, and then when you were a teenager probably, you craved for boys or girls. You grew up a little more, became an adult, you started craving for a Rolls Royce. From toys to boys to Rolls Royce, the object kept changing. But the pattern of the mind of craving remained the same. Are you noticing? So, what is the problem?
Some craving.
Is it the object which is the problem? What is the problem?
Craving.
This inner feverishness is a disease. I have to hold on to something. Okay, I can't hold on to this, let me hold on to this. I can't hold on to this, let me hold on to this. Oh, I can't hold on to this, let me hold on to this. Are you getting this? That is the disease. The feverishness inside. It's called desire or craving. Simple. Yeah?
Then what is longing? Like people run behind Guruji, like that's like a magnetic attraction. Like we don't know why we run, but we run.
Go, that's fine. Karo. I'm not saying don't observe what is happening to you. That is important.
Yeah.
You know. See, you ran behind toys. Mom gave you toys. No, dad gave you toys. Achha, theek hai, play. How much you want to play? One day came automatically. You dropped the toys. Did mom had to take that toy away from you? No, one day you drop that Barbie doll or whatever you played with. Trucks, cars. Yeah, you drop those things. Today, do you even remember which was your favorite toy? But at that moment, it was like, ah, my doll, I'm not giving it to you. One day, a natural maturity will happen. When that maturity happened, when you weaned away from the toys, you were not aware. I am saying now become aware that there is a feverishness for the Guru, there is a feverishness for spirituality, for knowledge, for whatever objects on the spiritual path, for becoming a teacher. So many other feverishness we pick up. Just observe, there is this feverishness inside me. That is the disease. The object is not the problem. Yeah? When you become more and more and more aware, you mature faster. That's all it is. It is a game of maturing faster. Anyway, you will mature when you are 80, 90 years old. You won't crave so much about running behind Guruji. You won't crave about sex, about money, about cars. But it's no use, that maturity, because there is no awareness. Throughout the process, there was no awareness of that feverishness inside. A new feverishness will start at the age of 90. Oh, my bones are paining. They should become fine. I should be able to eat. I should be able to digest. New feverishness will start. Are you getting this, what I'm saying? Recognizing that feverishness is a disease of the mind is the key. Yes, and you have to be a doctor to your own mind and treat it.
How discipline will play the role on this?
In fact, discipline only will play the role. What is the discipline for?
Perfection.
For what?
Become the master.
How? How will I become the master? What is the self-effort for? Present moment. Only one thing is there, guys. There's only one thing. He's taught you only one thing, really. Live in the present moment. Where is happiness?
Now.
Right now. When will I be happy?
Now.
Right now. He's teaching you the same thing, guys. Responsibility is the ability to respond when?
Now.
Yeah. Don't be a football of other people's opinions. When do you become a football? When you are in the past. So where should you be?
Now.
Right now. Are you seeing this? He's actually teaching you only one thing. Here. All this is discipline. Discipline of the mind. Doing pranayama even when I don't feel like it. Oh, what does it do really? What does pranayama do?
Flush out the toxins.
Yeah, it takes away a lot of toxins. With those toxins, what is really happening?
Cleansing. We are settling down much better.
Why do you settle down?
It's a blockage.
What blockage of what?
Thoughts and everything coming back.
Settle down.
Okay, how they settle down? What is the mechanism?
Cleansing happens of the pranas.
Cleansing of what is happening?
Pranas.
No,
the gandhis, sorry.
Okay, what is blocking the chakra? What is blocking your prana?
Thoughts.
Impressions. All impressions of the thoughts and emotions I have collected with my ragas and dveshas, these impressions make my inner environment heavy. That is what blocks the chakras. What is chakra really?
Junction.
The junction where the body and the mind meet. That gets blocked by all impressions, thoughts, emotions. Yeah. When I do pranayama, I'm controlling the prana, regulating the prana so that it cleanses out all these impressions. Are you getting it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, same thing in Bhastrika. Yeah, from the body level, I am cleansing the mind level. Slowly. Yes, and then in Kriya, when I'm breathing in and out, what am I doing? Have you noticed emotions come up? Someday you feel like crying, someday you feel like shouting. Why? Emotions start cleansing automatically. Yeah. It's amazing how it happens. But it happens. You have experienced it. Direct observation, right?
Yes.
At least once you've cried in your Kriya,
yes.
One little tear, so you know emotion comes up. Naturally it comes up. It gets cleansed. Yeah. And then the mind settles down. That settling of the mind, that becoming calm, is coming closer and closer to the Purusha that you are. Got it? So much effort is required at the Prakriti level to even establish in the Purusha. And that also 1 second you establish. Have you noticed? At the end of long Kriya sometimes, you know, after Soham when Guruji says lie down, somewhere you experience absolute silence. You're not even breathing. You're absolutely quiet. And then suddenly you start breathing. And all the thoughts come back. Finished. Gone. Have you noticed? That moment of absolute peace, that blankness is such a small window. Yeah? And so much effort we had to do just to get there. Why? Because we've trained our mind to collect so much negativity. Throughout the day we are collecting negativity. Yeah? So it's very, very important for us to move from a negative mind to a positive mindset. We'll be talking about that now. But before that, I've not even given you a break after Kriya, so I'll give you a restroom break. Those who want to continue can continue doing the Raga Dvesha, and we will start with the negative mind and the positive mind explanation after the break. Take a quick restroom break, guys.